Good morning and welcome back to Lillehammer. It's day 9 of competition at the World Para Snow Sports Championship. And you join us once again on the Alpine slopes. Today's event, it's the men's slalom. It's coming up shortly. Don't go anywhere. So thank you for joining us. Last day today for the men's individual medals in the slalom competition. A little bit dark on your screens there, but I can absolutely promise you in the distance from our commentary box, we can see the sun breaking through the clouds. It is going to be a lovely day. We've had interchangeable weather for the last couple of days of competition. We've had glorious sunshine, and then yesterday, my goodness, didn't the wind blow? Even down at the bottom of the slopes, we're sat right in front of the finish line, and it was truly gusting all around, even some of the signage coming out of the ground. Still hard conditions on the snow. It's almost -5, one of the coldest days we've had, in fact, here in Lillehammer. And just a vertical drop of only 160 metres for the slalom. 52 gates to contend with. And we're getting underway in just 3 or 4 minutes' time. Of course, the vision impaired, the first class to make their way down the slopes. And they are followed, as ever, by the standing and the sitting classes. So plenty of our already decorated contenders involved this morning and this afternoon. Two runs, of course. And here is the lineup for the VI class. Giacomo Bertagnoli will lead us out the gates with Andrea Ravelli. He was a gold medalist in the giant slalom a couple of days ago. Neil Simpson there, silver medalist earlier on in the week, and 13 contenders in total in the vision impaired class. In the standing, King Arthur, Mr. Bauché of France, having a fantastic championship, a gold and two silvers. He'll be hoping to add to that pot. Other big names in that one, Alexei Bugaev and Federico Pellizzari. Other medal winners already this week in the standing. And then to conclude, this is just run one, of course. We will have the sitting big field in the standing class today. And in the sitting, the home favorite, Jesper Pedersen. Already 2 golds and 2 silver. He will be going for 5 medals from 5 events. And his big contender, it's been one of the stories of the sitting. He's up against, again, Gideon Kampscher. They've been going head-to-head in every single class. It's been fantastic to watch. And, the number 4 there, Michael Golas, who will be 4th down in his bib. The G-bibs for the guides. And there, look, ready and raring to go, Giacomo Bertagnoli. He'll be first man down, he's in the gate. A bronze medal, a gold medal for him in the giant slalom. His first medal of the competition. Didn't make it for the first few events. Unfortunate positive COVID test, but as soon as he was negative, flew straight out and got a gold at the first time of asking. He was a very happy boy. And off we go. We're underway in the slalom. Run number 1. Bertagnoli is the current reigning Paralympic and World Cup champion. This is his event. This is the one he'll have had his eyes on his way out. Following closely behind Lavelli. Job number one, get yourself down twice. And he's got it down run one pretty quickly. Just coming into our vision here. It is a short run. Going to be around about 45 seconds for the quicker athletes. In fact, he goes well under that, doesn't he? 43.37 then is the time to beat.
43.37.
13 in the class. Finish time for the will anybody go quicker than the Italian? Ivan Frantsev of Team RPC. See, they're still covered in cloud up at the top. It will be the case for the first hour or two before the sun makes its way over to this finishing slope. It's plus 6.6 at the halfway mark. He's going to drop a little bit more time here on the bottom section. 2.58 behind Bertagnoli.
25, second best time for Ivan Frantsev. Middleflow Harhaus from Slovakia is in the
goal. Good number three, Miroslav Harhaus. A silver and a couple of bronzes for his efforts already this week. ...35-year-old. Didn't actually start alpine skiing until 2015. And, that's close, 0.28 behind his house.
New second best time.
That was to be anticipated. Three medals in his collection already in Lillehammer. The Pole, and Mikhail Golas. Yet to find his way onto the podium here. Just 17 years of age. His debut world championship. This isn't a bad time. Oh, he's lost a bit on the bottom half there. 87. Just 0.7 through the intermediate one. And lovely to see in front of our commentary box here, five or six real youngsters just watching the action, waving their Norwegian flags. And if they just look to their left-hand side, they're going to see Jacinthe Della Place, who has already won three gold medals and a bronze in these championships. He is, along with Bertagnoli, the man to watch. Could be a head-to-head between these two chaps, but he's 1.86 behind. In bid number six, Valery Redkozyubov, guided by Evgeny Geryov of Team RPC. So the 43.37 already looking like a fantastic time for Giacomo. 2.6 seconds behind for Redkozyubov. Now, Neil Simpson, silver medalist in the super combined. So he knows his way around a slalom course, guided by his brother, Andrew. Just 0.55 at timing gate one, and this looks quick down the bottom half. It's 1.96, good enough for fourth place. That is one successful run then for the Brits. Jakub Krakow. A bronze medal on day number one of competition. Guided by Branislav Rosman. He was a silver medalist at the Paralympics in Pyeongchang He'll be looking forward to Beijing, and he'll be looking forward to run number two as well, just 0.24 behind Bertagnoli. At the moment, anything within 2 seconds is going to be a top five time. Hagner, 0.15 ahead. First man we've seen ahead of Bertagnoli at any time in gates. And this looks tidy through the finish too. Takes it, gains time, 0.34 for Johannes Hagner. Two silver medals around his neck this week. Can he upgrade that to a gold? He's in golden position. Patrick Jensen of Australia, guided by Amelia Hodgson. Have a bit of trouble in the top half, 4.4. But as we've said so many times on these double run events, get yourself down to the bottom, just 13 in this class. And the Australian will cross the line in 9.5 over now Eigner's leading time. Damir Midrak, the Croatian, guided by Maria Koš. Took up the sport in 2007. He's also a PE teacher. Seven and a half seconds. Gets him into the top 10. Wang Mingyu is our penultimate athlete in the VI class. 25-year-old. Became interested in the sport after participating in a ski class. Also a keen runner, as well as alpine skier. Just a sensible run, 12.1 seconds. Looks pretty happy, one hand in the air. And our final athlete then in the vision impaired class is Karolis Verbligevicius, and he is a B1 alpine skier, the only in the class, which means he is completely unable to see. Blacktail glasses unfortunately goes over one of the early gates and he's out of the competition. Yeah, you just see that turning his skis in a bit too early. Ah, that's a real disappointment. Guided by Vitenis Makowskis. And now being guided down the slopes. You see his goggles there, completely blacked out. It's quite incredible to watch. Now, let's have a look at the results from run number one. Johannes Hagner, 43.03, the quickest time. Giacomo Bertagnoli, plus 0.34 behind, and in the top three, 0.58, Jakub Krakow. Miroslav Hraus also within just 0.62. On we go then, the men's standing class, run one of the slalom. And no introduction needed for King Arthur Bauchet. Two silvers, one gold already in Lillehammer. Having a great week. He's a silver medalist in Pyeongchang. Looking to go one better in Beijing in a month's time. And the current reigning slalom men's world champion. And he's cutting some fine lines. A dozen or so gates to come. He will set the clock for the rest to beat. And again, some big names later in this class. And he stops it at 41.14. And he should be fairly pleased with that, I imagine. No discernible errors or wides on his run. Next man out, Australian Mitchell Gawley. 29-year-old. Been on the slope since the age of 8. Mount Buller, Victoria, Australia. Didn't start racing till he was about 14 years of age. Been competing internationally since 2006. His time is just shy of 3 seconds behind Alpha Valche. Hilmar Orvalsson. Next out, representing Iceland, 2.31 through the first intermediate. Already you're seeing how good Valche's time was, the Frenchman. Clipping nicely through the bottom half and cheers at the bottom, you can hear. And lovely support there from the Icelander. He does go into second place. Hiroku Misawa of Japan. ...34-year-old. ...5.33... ...behind Valche. Spencer Woods of the United States. He was 25... just 4 days ago, so a birthday week for the American. A quote of his I like is, work hard in silence and let your success make the noise. An ambition to compete at Beijing next month. And he's had his first successful run here in the slalom, 7.63. Puts him in fifth place early on. Santeri Kiveri of Finland. Just 21 years old, but been skiing for about 15 years already. Slalom is his self-confessed number one. In fact, that was Thomas Charles Walsh. So we had no Santeri Kiveri. Oh, it was Kiveri. Yeah, so into third place, too, with 4.24. Sorry, the graphics on the screen there. And this is Tommy Walsh. Be another birthday boy next week on the 30th. He'll be 27 years of age. Did break his left ankle in 2017 at a Paralympic Games test event. Puts himself into fourth place with a 46.34. Oscar Burnham. He'll be trying to emulate his teammate, Valche. ...22 years old. done lower arm in an accident in 2018. Was planning to be a high mountain guide prior to that. And 3.7 seconds. That does put him into second place. That's a fantastic one. He is rightfully delighted. Thomas Fiel. Silver medal at the last World Championships in the slalom. And you can see how good Bouchet's top half of this run was. Nicely composed bottom half. He's going to lose a little bit more time. So 3:47, but again, second place for Thomas Fiel. So in silver medal position, looking to retain that or go better. Alexander Alibayev of Team RPC. ...32-year-old, followed his brother into the sport. Sport is his entire life, he says. And another one nips into second place, so a really good run of competitors now. Bouchet very happily sat in the leader's chair. Big wave from the Frenchman. And he might have that smile on his face for some time. It's a big field. So 38 athletes taking part in the standings. So he might want to get himself a jacket. He could be there for a little while. Thomas Groka. Really fighting the course down the bottom. Leaps into the line, plus 3.77.
He's fifth at the moment.
Fifth place.
Alexander
Tushin, RPC. At the moment, anything within 5 seconds is a top eight position. Alexei Mukushan. ...23 years old. Motto is only forward to new victories. And now we have a top 10 for the time being.
10th at the moment. Kasan Hoshio with Japan is in the course.
Kuei Takahashi. Out of the Nippon Sports Science University in Tokyo, Japan. Took part in the torch relay ahead of the 2020 Paralympic Games in Tokyo. His major ambition is to win a medal in Beijing.
47.76 for the Japanese.
Now, one of the top performers this week, Alexei Bugaev. And he's just got better and better this week. He's gone bronze, silver, silver, gold. Gold coming in the giant slalom. And this is really quick. Oh, nearly falls over the line. 1/100th of a second. Quicker than Arthur Bouchet. He found 0.3 in the bottom half. He shakes his head as if he's not too happy, but now the smile comes across his face. Well, it doesn't get any closer than this, and we're already set up for a fantastic second run this afternoon. Here comes Jesse Keefe. ...17 years old, Jesse Keefe. Born without an ankle bone in his right leg. He's hoping to make Sun Valley Ski Education Foundation pretty proud. I'm sure they will be as he crosses the line in 15th position.
At
gaining plenty of experience on the slopes in Lillehammer. Adam Hall of New Zealand. ...34 years old. That stomach complaint affected him in 2014 in Sochi. So we have Katarona in New Zealand. And this is a good time for Hall. That's going to put him in the top five, top three even, 2.42. Fantastic for the New Zealander. And there's your new leader, Alexei Bugaev. So Arthur Balshay has made way out of the leaders' chair, but he can now go back and get inside in the warm. Robin Kusch. 23 years old. His parents and his coaches most influential in his career, says Robin. And a 46.51 puts him inside the top 15. James Whitley, 24-year-old from Great Britain, also enjoys swimming, fishing and watching Formula One, apart from the final lap in Abu Dhabi maybe. And he is cutting some fairly nice lines here in the bottom half, 5.07, puts him in the top 10. He's another athlete hoping to compete in Beijing. Just getting closer and closer. Jordan Brossan of France. ...28-year-old... living in Landgraaf in the Netherlands. Idol is alpine skier Marcel Hirscher. And another one around about the 5 second mark over the time of Bugaev and Balshay. So it's a very competitive, you've got your top two that are a couple of seconds ahead of the rest, but then the bronze medal at the moment, you've got about 10 or 15 athletes within 3 to 5 seconds. Federico Pellizzari, a bronze medal in the super combined. And 2.78, top five, knocks Thomas Feel out of fifth place position. Aron Lindström of Sweden, 21 years old. And he's seventh in the giant slalom at the 2000 World Cup event in Japan. Says this sport is all about continuing to believe in yourself. There's a congenital limb impairment affecting his left hand and forearm. But it doesn't stop him getting within 5 seconds of Bugaev. And at the moment, it looks like sort of that 5 second window is the mark to keep yourself in the game. Christoph Glotzner of Germany. ...19 years old, first ever World Championships. And he's had a pretty tidy first run here. 19th position. Again, some fantastic support down the bottom here. And a big wave to the crowd. And he's fairly satisfied with himself there. I do promise you the sun is coming. You can see it in the distance. Jules Sages of France. Another 19-year-old, but skiing since the age of three. Born into a skiing family. Said it was very natural for him to put skis on at a young age. And again, all this experience of being around world and Paralympic champions. Probably wouldn't have come here looking for medals. But to get plenty of runs on the World Championship course, and he's doing that. Andrei Chedny, one of our single leg skiers, the Pole. And he's nipping through the final gates. Should be 6 or 7 seconds, 8.7. 24th place, and we've got around about 10 athletes to come. Next up, Australia's Jonty O'Callaghan. 24 years old. Started skiing in Europe with his family. So still resides in Australia, New South Wales. Suffer some blood clots in 2018, so. Oh, and he's down, Jonty. That's a real shame for the Australian. But thankfully, always nice to see them get straight back up. Manuel Bodanks. Huge French contingent in this field. 1 second behind early on. Oh, he's a tiny bit wide there. It's back in online. Oh, and he's gone wide again. Oh, he just couldn't control that. Pretty close to the finish too. Head back to the final pole. Oh, he'll be frustrated. Yeah, the right ski just found its way into the air. And this is so nip and tuck so quick, it's almost impossible to recover. He gave it a great effort, got around the next gate, but then head to the heavens, and that is the slalom done. Patrick Hallgren of the United States. 29-year-old, only began para skiing at age 23. Sustained a serious knee injury during the winter of 2018-19. And as with so many athletes, oh, he's happy there. He's delighted. Yeah, outrudder being swung in a windmill formation. And good noise at the bottom for him too. Roger Puidavi of Romania. Years old. Began skiing his home nation of Andorra at the age of three. And, was skiing before and after his accident. His coach, Jordi Cabanel, will be pleased to see him in the top 20 spots. By the look on his face, I think he could have run a little bit quicker. I mean, I'm sure every athlete crosses the line thinks, could have had a bit more time out there. Well, I'm very looking forward to seeing these results at the end of this first run. There are so many athletes in that 3 to 5 second range. It's going to be an absolute battle for the bronze specifically. And Leander Kress, 7.88 for 24th place, and another pretty chuffed with themselves. Andrew Harahay, 26. athlete with cerebral palsy, resides in Aspen, Colorado. And he says, don't let anyone tell you that you can't do something. So many inspirational stories amongst these world championships. And Andrew Harahay, 8.94. Behind you, now longtime leader, Alexei Bugaev. So into our final five or six, Ivan Vasilev. And unfortunately, makes it very, very close to the finish line. But just being thwarted a few gates before the finish line. Jeffrey Stoet, 26-year-old from the Netherlands. Did win bronze in the downhill and the Super G at the 2017 World Championships in Italy. Another with a fairly recent injury, 2018. Broke his foot. But he's broken through the finish line on run number one. And the cowbells ring at the bottom of the slopes here in Norway. Kakuta Koike of Japan. Got some fantastic snowboarders as well, Japan. Oh, just a tiny touch wide, cutting beautifully though. And this is a tiny little run for Koike. Single pole skier, right hand. And he will successfully complete run number one, 23rd position. Martin Moxley should be in the gate, the American. There he is. 41 years old, Martin Moxley. Says never doubt your abilities. He enjoys all kinds of outdoor activities, inspired to take up the sport after watching Canadian para-alpine skiing Stefan Ellefsen on the slopes in Telluride in Colorado. Only been on the slopes 6 or 7 years as Moxley. Resides in Grand Junction, and I'm sure his partner Jessica and all six children are going to be cheering him on from home. And there is run number one done. 31st place. That's irrelevant, though. And again, more rounds of applause. Fantastic to see the support, regardless of what flag you're wearing or flag you're holding. Just the great respect from everyone around the venue. Home skier, Marcus Nielsen-Grasto. Third from last to go in the standing class. He's already making his way to the finish. 13.18 for Marcus. And multiple cowbells for the home skier. Arvid Skoglund. Years old, another debut world championship athlete, born with a limb deficiency as a result of the effects of dysmelia, and he crosses the line in 24th position after run number one. Took up the sport for fun originally, and it's got a little bit more serious now. And finally, Remy Mazzi. ...33 years old. Took out para-athletics initially, back in 2018, and then turned his sights on the slopes about 10 years later. He concludes the standing class in 30th place. So let's have a look then. Look at this. Bugaev, Bauche, 1/100th of a second separating arguably the two favourites in the field. And then the fight at the moment for bronze, Hall, Alibayev, Pelizari and Feel. Let's put Burnham in there too. Just a couple of seconds between those five or six. So the men's slalom in the standing this afternoon in run two is going to be a sight you won't want to miss. Coming up next, the sitting. So we're not hanging around, we're going straight into the sitting class. And first out the gates is Norway's Jesper Pedersen. He is the one the locals have come to watch. He is the national hero at these World Championships. Two golds, two silvers. And look, there we go. Jesper Solvik Pedersen. I think he's the only man with his own poster banner down at the finish line. And it just shows the love the Norwegians have for this man. Just 21 years old. And in Norway, winning his first World Championships. It's been an incredible week. No matter what happens for the rest of the week, it's already been absolutely sensational for Jesper. Can he get a trio of golds? This is run number one. He's a silver medalist at the last World Championships in Slovenia, Kranjska Gora. And he's been going head-to-head this week with Jerion Kampscher. He goes in seven or eight athletes' time. But Jesper Pedersen gets to set the mark. And he seems to be going pretty nicely too. Last few slopes cutting through. Can't see anything wrong with this time. It's nice, it's 42.06. So that's the time to beat. And his fans are delighted. He never gives too much away, a smile and a wave. Quite often this week he's crossed the finish line and just sort of shrugged. But no, he is happy with that one. Jurnej Slivnik, second out from Slovakia. 21 years old. Trained six or seven times a week. He's up on the slopes in the winter and heavily a gym goer in the summer. And introduced to the sport in a demonstration camp by another famous para-alpine skier in Slovakia. He crosses the line 3.8 seconds behind the time of Pedersen. Jasmine Bamba. Oh no. Can they keep going? So if you come to an absolute stop, then that is your time done. So that might go to the jury. Did he absolutely come to an absolute stop? It was pretty close. But let's keep going for the time being. So, of course, there's going to be lots of time lost. But, again, we talk about experience, making a couple of runs down the slope. You want to get into run two. It is a fairly healthy number of competitors in the sitting class this morning. And 12.6, so only 4 seconds lost, really, on the second half after losing his entire speed at the top of the slope, just a few gates in. So you could call that a success, really, for Bamba. Floris Meyer. So already coming through the finish line. Going to be 5 or 6 seconds behind, 5.17. And a respectful clap from Pedersen. Towel around his shoulders just to keep himself warm. Again, a little bit like, another one. Oh, that didn't stop. He can keep going here. Absolutely fine. Bit of trouble from Pavel Bambasek. Not having the greatest of times on run one, and no, calls it a day. That's enough for me. Such a... It's the technical event here in the Alpine slopes. And the smallest of errors get magnified. Ravi Drugan of the United States. 32 years old. Been on the slopes for just over a decade. Resides in Eugene, Oregon, United States. Just having a bit of trouble maintaining speed. And, as we've seen a couple of times, as soon as that speed, you lose a little bit to gain it back again. You're fighting such a huge battle. Also enjoys a bit of autocross. And he's back home. And he will complete a successful run one. Nods over the line, 9.65 behind Pedersen. Currently, still good enough for fourth position. You've got to get down. If you get down twice, you're always in with a chance. Victor Pirel of France. Birthday boy in 2 days' time. He's going to be moving into his 30s. And he's been skiing the vast majority of that since the age of three. He has competed in World Cups, yet to podium. But this is a great time for Victor. He's surely second place. Yeah, it is 1.14. That is fantastic. Coming off the back of a shoulder injury last year. And he's got his goal set on the next two Paralympic Games. Igor Sigorsky, bronze medal. Sorry, silver medal, forgive me, in the men's giant slalom a couple of days ago. He'll be looking to get back on those three steps. Got a big job to do to catch Pedersen at the moment. Capture still to come. Oh, well, he's just got, oh my goodness, he's got tight there, but he's made it through. Great little recovery. Cutting some very fine lines, Sikorsky. Markus Kvatakova of Austria. 30 years old. Oh. Again, just a few inches offline. And in fact, I'm sure he missed that gate. He's kept on going and he's definitely missed that one. So that is job done for Marcus, and he's having a bit of a training run now. Here he is then, Pedersen's big competitor, Jelion Kamschuler. A gold and a silver. And an unfortunate fall in the giant slalom a couple of days ago, where he was really fighting for gold place versus Pedersen. But he's 0.74 down in the top half. What could he do, the man from the Netherlands? He's going to go into second place. Looks like it. Third. So they are split by Victor Pirel. 1.18 behind Pedersen. 400 behind second place Pirel. Just a couple of deep lines there. Maybe taking a couple of kilometers per hour off his speed. His teammate Niels Delangen, also a medalist at these championships, a bronze for Delangen in the super combined. And this is going to be a very close top four now by the looks of things. 1.15 would again split them. Fourth place, 2.31, lost a three quarters of a second or so on the bottom half. But again, great support down the bottom. Lou Brazdegan, the Frenchman. ...26-year-old, out early, unfortunately. Let's have a quick replay here. Yeah, just a big lean to the left. Did get back up. But again, these gates so close. Very fine margins. Near on impossible to get yourself back online. We shall wait now for Kyle Tallman of the United States. Already in the bottom half, and he's another one that goes down. So is the course getting a little bit trickier? And he does come to a full stop, there'll be no recovery. That's what that, three of the last five not making it to the finish line. And again, just a rut or something dislodging the monoski from its line. And now, number 63, that is Kyle Tallman. So, got himself back upright and made his way down to the bottom. But he will be classed, unfortunately, as a DNF for the American. Next in the gate, should expect to see Argentina's Enrique Plante. And there he is. Factor time there on your screen if you're new to Alpine Sports. That is the speed relevant to 100%, the speed the clock runs at. So you will, you can see visually here the clock running a little bit slower than you'd expect. That is at 74% of normal time. And these factors based on impairments, so you will see them vary. And now, so nice looking run for Plante. Just waiting for a come to interview here. That's a deep one in there, but makes it, that's fine. So Plante now into the nip and tuck gates here. A dozen or so to navigate. And he'll be only the second man to reach the bottom in the last half a dozen. And that'll put him in a fairly good position too, going into run two. Just a little bit of a nudge at the end. Eighth position though for the Argentine. Han Sang-min of Korea. And again, there's a, do you know what? That's the third or fourth athlete now in that exact same position, just as they go down the final slope. The finish line is in view, and there's a rut, or there's something in the snow there that is really putting off a few of our sit skiers. Now, the athletes at the top of the slope, they do have an opportunity, of course, to watch what's going on. This is a really bumpy finish, actually, for Han Sang-min. But he makes his way over the line. And it's good enough for top 10. As we say so often, get across the line. And you never know, especially with two runs here in such a the technical event. So, here we go then. This is the little rutted area. Murat Pelli navigates to Siwa again. My goodness. So Pelli can't make it either. He goes at it exactly the same spot. Just referencing at the top of the slope, the other athletes do have an opportunity if they wish to see what's going on. In fact, I think he tried to avoid the rut there, but too much drastic action and missed the gate entirely. Dan Sheen of Great Britain. 40 years old is Dan. Now being really careful here. And I think that's a pretty good tactic. Just getting his outrigger slightly caught in one of the gates. And we're away. Did he make it through? He's getting back online. Feels like it's okay. Right, this is the turn here now. This left-hander, he's taking it well. Maybe slow and steady is the way now. Still got around about 15 or so, or 10 maybe, athletes to come. And they'll be aware that there is a turn that is causing difficulties, and he's just outside our wind now. He's going to make his way to the finish line. And that should be classed as a success. 25 seconds, ignore the time. He's in 13th place, but he's down. Alex Slegg, fellow Briton. Now, difficulty through the first gate and the second. Did he come to a full stop? He's carrying on. And we're really making some ruts now on these slopes. And I think, yeah, he's at the side of the slope. He's called the slalom a day. So we're going to move to Australian Josh Hanlon. Will be in the starting gates next. So major difficulties for the sit skiers. And that's the advantage of going out early. You maybe don't get a chance to see what else is going on, but you do get the best of the underski conditions. Josh Hanlon, this is like the best run for a little while, you know. Gliding through the turns. Anything within 10 seconds is going to put you in the top 10. 4.39 at the first intermediate. He's through the tricky section. That was it right there. From there, you can see the finish line. And if he can maintain his pace, he could be in the top 7 or 8 positions here. And he's going to cross the line. He'll be in the top 10. He's 9th, 7.36. And a couple of respectful nods. Anybody at the moment, again, just getting down is that. Is achieving Aaron Ewan of New Zealand. ...25 years old New Zealander. Another one down at that section. Wow. An experienced Aaron Ewan. And he's sent the gate on a journey down the slope, so might be a very short delay. They've got a spare, in fact. I'll put one straight in. Maybe they were expecting that. Down to the left-hand side. So that'll be one to watch on run two later on this afternoon. I'll make that 7 or 8 athletes down at the exact same point. A couple of those do manage to recover. And there's the gate sent on its journey down the slopes. Pascal Clisten. Can the Swift athlete complete run number one? 29 years old, only took up the sport in 2017, so one of the less experienced sit skiers. Massive concentration required from Pascal, and another one goes. And can he maintain a little bit? He's going to get back on course, because he knows very well that just finishing puts you in a not too bad position. He's through the tricky section at the top of the final slope. Just taking his time. So as we go through this, there's going to be, we talk about the one tricky section, but more are created. The more athletes that do make it, and he has done so. And his time, 16.79, 13th position. And 25 competing in total in the city. And this is Robert Enegel. And did he make it through that gate? I think he didn't. No, he's going to call that a day two. The 38-year-old from Bozeman, the United States. Adam Bording Nørbær of Denmark. ...21 years old, first world championship. Skiing at the age of 7. Spinal cord injury, his impairment. Right then, this is the section. Left, right, and left again. And that's very nice indeed. Now, there's about a dozen or so gates from the finish line. Anything within 7 or 8 seconds is going to get you into the top 10. That's what he was through timing gate number one. And this is a very tidy finish for Nørbær. And 13th place, 14 seconds behind your leader, who has been sat in the leader's chair the entire duration of this class. He went out first, Jesper Pedersen. Nobody yet within a full second of the Norwegian. and it's very, very unlikely that will happen. Petr Dreos. And just like the man before him, Nerber, just taking things sensibly. ...35 years old, Petr Dreos. Oh, he's so close to the line. He will recover and make it over. He will have lost several seconds just on that one turn. 14th place for the Czech. And we have four athletes to come. Bib number 75, Degun Yang. And it's over very, very early for the South Korean. Not what he would have wanted at all. So we go straight on to Richard Dumity, Hungarian. Factor time of 67%. Been mono skiing for about 8 years. Also does hand cycling when the weather's better. And he wishes that that run could have been better. So another falls foul to the difficult course here for the sit skiers in Lillehammer. And we have just two more attempts to get down. First up, Vladimir Girov. Just wait till the course is clear. Of course, Girov may have already started. They don't wait till they're right at the bottom till they let the next runner go. But Dumity will just make his way to the bottom of the course. Down the gate, a couple of gates. In fact, Girov will not be taking part, so Dashkan Abasov will be our last competitor. And he's in the gate there. 39 years old, Abasov. First World Championships. And he's the last man down a treacherous course. The Azerbaijani. His goal is to compete. He's another one goes down very early on. Really disappointing. So the field of 25 in the sit skis is going to be down. I make it to about 15 or so for this afternoon's second run. Now, Dashkan's carrying on here. But now he's So Dashkan continues. He'll gain a bit of experience just by continuing down the course. And again, is that so many spots now? Now, between run one and run two, they do, of course, have a little run down the course and improve the conditions. But with the sit skiers going third behind the VI and the standing, it's always going to be slightly more cut up, but maybe not to the extent we've just seen over the last 20 minutes or so. So it just puts those in the top five or six positions, makes their runs just even the more impressive. Jesper Pedersen, best of the conditions, first man out, 42.06. Nobody got within a second, only Victor Pirel and Julian Kempscher within 1.5. Niels de Langen still very much involved, as is Sikorski, Slivnik, and Floris Meyer. Anybody beyond 5 seconds with a lot of work to do. But we very much look forward to another Pedersen and Kempscher head-to-head. And Victor Pirel, can he spoil the party? So plenty of stories to tell from run number one here in Lillehammer in the slalom competition. We are back with you at 1:30 for the second run. My goodness me, we are incredibly excited. We hope you are too. We'll see you a little bit later.
Come on, come on, come on. Tusen takk.
All right, good. He is going.